So I have a crazy idea, and I thought I would include you in this idea and film some of it. So basically, I am invited to a wedding that is going to take place in about a week, next weekend in the beginning of October. And I do have a few dresses or outfits that I could wear that I've already made. And I do like to reuse my makes in an effort to be sustainable with what I make. But I kind of want to make something new. And I have this absolutely gorgeous viscose that I've had in my stash for about 2 years. I bought it from Blackbird Fabrics a while ago. Yeah, at least 2 years ago. And I have been waiting for a project, for an idea for this fabric, and I have been struck with inspiration, and so let me talk you through it. So basically, this fabric is a viscose twill fabric. And it's quite light, as you can see. And it's sort of autumnal in the colors, and so I've never made anything for the summertime with this fabric, and I've always been drawn to it in the autumn. But because it's viscose, it doesn't keep me very warm. And so there was a very short period of time in the season when I could actually wear this fabric without being freezing cold. And also, I've been tempted to make something glamorous with this fabric because it is just soft and bouncy and just lovely. And I love the colors and the print. And I want to make something, yeah, fabulous. And so I figured an October wedding would be the perfect occasion. And I have just figured out which pattern I want to make. So I would like to make another Sauvie dress. So, a Sew House 7 Sauvie dress. I made a previous one in a light blue linen from Pretty Mercerie that I showed you in my first video. And I loved wearing that to two summer weddings. It was a lot of fun to dance in and move around in, and it was just, the perfect amount of glamour that I feel comfortable with. And I want to make another one. So, making it into viscose would change the way that the garment turns out in the end, because it is a lighter fabric than a cotton or a linen. And so I've thought about ways to stabilize it. It is recommended as a possible fabric in the pattern, but I do know that it's not going to be as stiff, or it's not going to have as much hold as a cotton or a linen. And so I've planned on what I'm going to do is I'm going to interface with an iron-on interfacing the bodice piece, because that seems to be the piece that drapes the most in a lighter fabric, and I want it to have some hold, just like the linen and cotton. Maybe just not just like it, but a little bit more than a viscose fabric would hold. And there is a facing. I'm going to be using. So there's a facing in the bodice. That's the entire bodice piece on the inside down to the waist, and I'm going to be using some leftover black viscose that I have. It's all wrinkled. I will iron it first. that I have just so that I can save as much of this absolutely gorgeous fabric as possible for perhaps other projects if I have some remaining over. Probably not a whole lot, maybe just bias binding. But yeah, so that's my plan. I think it will have a different effect in this viscose fabric. I think that there probably won't be as much volume in the skirt, for example, and in the flare at the bottom of the skirt. But I think it does have enough drape where it's gonna be fun anyway. It's gonna be pretty no matter what. And yeah, and this larger print I think will be better in a larger garment as well, because I thought it was a little bit too overwhelming just to make a top in this fabric, because I think next to my face it's a little bit strange, but I think in a dress it'll make sense because it'll be from head to toe. And I didn't want to waste 2.5 meters. I think I have about 2.5 meters on another skirt because I have so many skirts. And so, yeah, the tricky part of this project is that I have exactly 9 days. It is currently Friday, September 23rd, and the wedding is next Saturday. So I have, I think, 8 days because I can't count the day of the wedding, obviously. And I have a full-time job and two other projects that I'm making that need to be delivered that weekend. So yeah, this is gonna be fun. This is gonna be a bit of a challenge, and I wanted to take you along with me. So I will keep you up to date with how I'm going, and this will be a fun sew-along under stress. So here are my supplies, and I think I have everything that I need. So I have my fashion fabric, which I just showed you, and in this video it looks like it's a dark blue background, but it is in fact black. And so yeah, I have about 2.6 meters of this fabric and I need 2.8, but since I will be using this black, it looks like tencel fabric actually, this black tencel fabric for the bodice facing, then I think that will save me at least half a meter in what I need out of the fashion fabric on the inside of the garment, and I think it'll be fine. And then I have my black viscose interfacing. It's this very lightweight, you can use it for jersey as well, for stretch fabrics, I mean. It's very this very light interfacing, and it works well with viscose. And then I have enough thread, I have plenty of needles, and I'll probably use a size 70 needle. And then I have elastics. So I want to try using this elastic. It's 4 centimeters wide, like the pattern calls for. And this is meant to be used for shirring in patterns. And I've been looking for elastics that are a little bit less bulky, because this is what you traditionally use, or this is what you can find for garment sewing. And it's this very almost cardboard-like thick elastic. And it does kind of cut into the skin a little bit. I have very sensitive skin, and so anything that'll feel soft against my skin is welcome. And so, yeah, I've been looking for alternatives. And so I have some of this if this doesn't end up working out, but I do want to try this. My haberdashery recommended it for waistbands, and I think it will match this fabric a lot better, because this sort of elastic kind of is very bulky on the other side of a viscose fabric, and it can kind of stick out. I think this lighter elastic will be much better with the weight of this fabric. Also, it's okay that it's white. I know that it exists in black as well, but it's going to be encased within the front bodice and the bodice facing, so it doesn't matter what color it is, and it won't show through to the other side because this fabric is pretty opaque. So yeah, I have everything. I don't need to go to the haberdashery. That will save me a lot of time. Hooray! I just wanted to update you really quickly on where I am with this dress. So it is currently Monday, September 26th, and I have until Friday to finish it. This weekend I did work on it a little bit, but I didn't get a whole lot done just because I had a whole lot of other things going on as well. Like I wanted to finish making a secret project for a friend who's giving birth soon, and I wanted to finish making a little bunny for her baby, which you can see is visiting my sewing corner here until I gift him, because I've become attached to him. But I did manage to cut out the pattern. You can see all the pieces are here. I did manage to cut out the whole thing, cut out the facing in this Coudre fabric. I managed to stay stitch all the edges that might relax a little bit, and I interfaced the front and back of the top part of the fashion shop fabric to reinforce the fabric a little bit at the bodice. So yeah, now I just need to get sewing. Wish me luck. And welcome to my bathroom. Sorry for the echo. And also, it's nighttime, so there's not a whole lot of natural lighting, but I hope you can see. It is currently Wednesday, September 28th, and I have until Friday to finish this. But I have basically, sorry, my throat's kind of sore. We don't have the heat on yet at work, and it's cold all day, every day, and I'm suffering. Anyway, I basically finished this dress last night.
I have a few finishing touches to put on it, and I am very happy with it. I will not be wearing it barefoot, obviously, but just to give you an idea. Yeah, it's got pockets, and it's swishy, and I'm happy. Anyway, and I think that this fabric works really well with this dress. It's the right size. So basically, there are a few things I want to do to fix it, because as you can see, it's a little bit loose on me, especially in the bodice area. It's hanging, the waistband is hanging here, and it should be a little bit higher. My natural waist is a little bit higher. And so I think I'm going to take it in at the waist, or at least make the elastic a little bit shorter so that it pulls it in a little bit. And then also the neckline is sitting kind of low, and so I need to shorten the straps. And you can kind of see it's hanging a little bit too low in the armhole here on the arm side. And also in the back, you can kind of see my bottom band of my bra is kind of sticking out. And I would like to wear a bra with this, so. So yeah, I'm going to, instead of unpicking it because it's too late now, I've already understitched and notched all of the seam allowances along the neckline and also the arm side. So I think that unpicking it now will just make this seam too fragile, especially because this fabric's a little bit looser woven than a cotton or linen fabric, for example. So I'm just going to fold the excess underneath and just stitch it down. I think it won't be noticeable and only I will know. So yeah, I'm gonna do that tonight. Keep watching Gilmore Girls to keep me company. And yeah, I'm really happy with how it's turning out. I think it looks good. And it'll be ready for Friday.
Hi everybody, so it is currently Friday and we have our train to go to Lille because the wedding's actually in Belgium in a few hours. So I have basically finished. I finished most of it last night, the modifications I wanted to do, just because Thursday I was too tired. I couldn't do it. So I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. Let me show you. So like I talked about, I took in the waistband by about 14 centimeters, but I can't remember how big I cut it in originally, so that doesn't really matter. But I took it in, tried it on, and then sewed it up. And then I also took in the shoulder straps about 3 centimeters. And yeah, I think it works. I have it on right now. It looks a little bit bulky because I have it on right now with a V-neck camisole underneath for warmth, because I wanted to try out how warm I'll be because this wedding is taking place in Belgium and it's cold. So yeah, I have on a half slip underneath. I'm thinking of wearing these tights, so not opaque but semi-opaque. And then these shoes, because I can't walk in any heels higher than this. I think it looks good. I think the only other thing that I'm gonna try and do before we leave is, in the instructions it's optional, but you can sew 2 lines of stitching along the elastic here. And that's what I did for my first one in the blue linen viscose blend. And I find it, actually without it, here, let me get closer so you can see. Ugh. I think it's actually kind of bulky without the stitches, so I think I'm going to do that really quickly before we leave. Sorry about the camera angles. This is hard in my left hand. And then it's finished, and all I have to do is, on the train, I will be taking out the gathering stitches in the panel here, because I forgot to do that, but that I can do by hand. And I think also for warmth, I'll probably wear it with a cardigan. So if I could get cold, I could always wear it with this Jenna Cardi in this black knit fabric. It's kind of, it's got like a lace finish on it that I made a few years ago, and that is really useful. And then I also have this wool sweater cardigan as well that I bought from Cezanne last year, because I can't knit that fast. And I also wanted to get something of somewhat good quality. So if I'm really cold, I can always put this on over it or instead of the Jenna cardigan, and I think it'll be okay. So yeah, I'm gonna go and speed sew the waistband, this line of stitching on the waistband, really quick. And oh, I'm also making a clutch because I'm crazy. I had some leftover black wool fabric from a skirt I made a few years ago. And I thought, hey, why not make a clutch? And I found a YouTube video tutorial
from Rascol. It's a French haberdashery online. But yeah, it's very floppy. I'll show you later. But I need to sew on a snap so that it closes, and then a button for decoration. And yeah, I'll show you that soon. And hopefully this dress, maybe not at the party, but before the party when I'm all made up and ready. All right. Whew. A few days after the wedding, and I am back home, and we had a really great time. So it's always really nice to celebrate something so joyous in someone's life with them, and it's great to see different people's personalities through their weddings and what they want to express and show you and dance to. And yeah, we had a great time. And this dress was great for the event as well. It was comfortable and not too cold, so I had it on with a V-neck camisole and tights underneath and a cardigan over top that I didn't get to take off, but that's okay. And yeah, it was great. So this version is definitely different from the first version I made because it's in this lighter viscose, but I like the way it moves as well. It's much more flowy, not as stiff, and so the volume looks different. And it worked with the modifications that I made. So I shortened the straps 3 centimeters and I pulled in the waist elastic a little bit. And other than that, I didn't make very many other modifications. I added, so for example, you can see here, I added the 2 lines of stitching over the elastic, which is optional in the pattern. And this was, in the end, necessary, not only for the extra bulk that I pointed out earlier, but also because this elastic that I mentioned that I wanted to try out does work better with this viscose fabric, and it is more comfortable. For example, just pulling, it doesn't hurt as much if it pulls, but it twists so easily. Even fixed at the side seams like I had done, like the pattern suggests, it was twisting just all over the place. And so I think that was also why it looked bulky on the outside. And so I did add these 2 lines of stitches, not only to define my waist a little bit more, but also to hold this elastic down. and it was very difficult to work with, but in the end, I think it pays off because it works better with this fabric and it feels very comfortable. So just to keep in mind, just in case you want to try this as well. So I also had enough time to make a clutch. This is an envelope style clutch in a wool fabric. You can see it's a little bit textured here. This is leftover fabric from a skirt that I have previously made. And I also used some lining, oops, sorry to open. Some lining fabric I had left over, just in black as well. And yeah, and it worked out really well. You can see it's kind of floppy, so it's not the most practical clutch, but last minute and matching my outfit out of some scrap fabric, great. So I will link in the description the video. It's in French, but I'm sure you can figure it out. It's pretty self-explanatory. And I also use this button. I really love this button. This is from a friend's grandparents' button stash. When they passed away, she asked me if I wanted to have their button stash, and I said yes. And this is the first and only time I've accepted, just because I don't have much use for 1 or 2 buttons at a time. I usually need more. And so this is sufficient for a button stash for a while. And so yeah, I really love this one because it's got like a bluish gray style to it, or color to it. And yeah, I think it looks really nice. And whenever I look at it, I think of her and remember her grandparents, even though I didn't meet them. They had great style probably. And yeah, I'm happy with it. In the end, I'm really happy with this project. I surprised myself in that I was able to make it a lot faster than I thought I was going to be able to. I finished it, I think I said on Tuesday or Wednesday, and then was able to modify it and make sure that it fit me correctly. This is one thing I love about sewing. It's that I can sew something that I feel comfortable with and for an event, so that there's more of my personality in what I wear for something that's a life event for me as well. Because, you know, weddings are for
others, but also, you know, everybody makes memories. And to be able to wear something that fits me and that's comfortable, that's great. And so that's also why a lot of times I don't do these projects last minute like this, or I don't do projects that have to be done in a short amount of time, just because usually that means that you take shortcuts or you don't finish it as nicely. I find that kind of wasteful, in that if I were to do that, I know it would resemble a little bit more fast fashion. Like, I might make decisions that in the end don't suit me, or that I haven't thought out as much. I like to take my time with my sewing, and I like to be intentional when I sew. And so, yeah, this is not something I do often, but I do like to sew for events and for big events in my life as well. And so I'm pretty happy that I was able to finish this and that I had enough time. Anyway, I hope you like this more sewing vlog style behind the scenes video. I do hope to make videos like this more in the future, just because I think it's interesting to see how these sewing projects come to happen instead of just a collection of what I've sewn over a season. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you again soon. Bye.